1868 being the date and the year. Those Waterloo sportsmen did grandly appear to gain the great prizes and bear them away, never counting on Ireland and Master McGrath. On the 12th of December, that day of renown, McGrath and his trainer, they left Lurgantown. John Walsh was a trainer and soon they got off. For the very next day they touched England's great shore. And when they arrived there in big London town, those great English sportsmen all gathered around. And one of those gentlemen gave a ha-ha, "Is that the great dog you call Master McGrath?" And one of those gentlemen standing around says, "I don't give a damn for your Irish greyhound." And another, he laughs with a great ha-ha-ha, "We'll soon humble the pride of your Master McGrath." Well, Lord Lorgan steps forward and says, "Gentlemen, is there any among you has money to spend? For you nobles of England, I don't give a straw. Here's 5,000 to one on me, Master McGrath." Well, the slips were let loose and amid a great roar, the greyhound swept on like great waves to the shore. To a dead even break for old Erin Gobrah, sure they tore round the course led by Master McGrath. Well, the hearse she led on just as swift as the wind, he was sometimes before her and sometimes behind. Well, he jumped on her back and he held up his paw. 3 cheers for old Ireland and Master McGrath. We've seen many greyhounds that filled us with pride in the days that are gone, and it can't be denied that the greatest and gamest the world ever saw was a champion of champions, bold Master McGrath. Was a champion of champions, bold Master McGrath.